There's so much to go over for the new Disney Cruise Line ship, the Disney Wish, that I can't do it all in one video. It's just gonna be in segments. This is segment number one, dining experiences. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm SwishWilly, aka Lindsay, and if you're new here, welcome. I talk about all things Disney, so if you're into that sort of thing, make sure you hit subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. So as most of you know, the Disney Cruise Line has just unveiled their newest ship, the Disney Wish, and there's so much to cover that I'm gonna have to do this in segments, otherwise we're gonna be here for a while. And for today's segment, we're gonna be focusing on all the dining experiences that you can have while you're on board. A bunch of new dining experiences are coming to the ship, and some old favorites may be joining the ship as well. Let's start with the all ages experiences, the stuff you can enjoy as a family. So I'm excited for all of these new experiences. They all sound really cool. So if you hear me say, oh, I'm really excited about that, I'm excited about all of it. So there may be some repetition in here. So the first one we're gonna talk about is for all you Frozen fans out there. And if you're not a Frozen fan, chances are someone in your family is. So you're gonna wanna take one for the team and enjoy this experience because it's gonna be one to remember. So the name of the Frozen dining experience is simply called Arendelle, a Frozen Dining Adventure. And the reason why they called it this is because you're gonna get transported into the Kingdom of Arendelle. Who could ask for anything more? What is bringing you to Arendelle exactly? Queen Anne and Kristoff are celebrating their engagement and you're invited. You're a guest of honor. And of course, you're gonna see other guests of honor such as Elsa and Olaf. And of course, with the two of them joining in the festivities, it's inevitable that you're gonna have some incredible musical performances. You may have noticed that the Frozen Ever After attraction in Epcot is based out of the Norway Pavilion. And to play off of that, while you're enjoying these musical performances, you can expect some amazing Norwegian cuisine. And rumor has it that this Norwegian cuisine is gonna be cooked by Åken himself. Some say this will be a dinner worth melting for. Now, not all of us have people that love Frozen in our families. Chances are you do, but if you don't and you have a whole bunch of Marvel lovers in your family, you're also in luck. The next new dining experiences exclusive to the Disney Wish is the Avengers Technology Showcase. The cuisine on this dining experience is gonna be really interesting and really, really cool. All of the cuisine is gonna be based on your favorite Marvel heroes. So you're gonna have a very expansive global menu. The cuisine options are gonna be going from your classic American fare all the way to the rich flavors of Africa. So this menu is gonna be great for those picky eaters who like to stick to what they know, but it's also gonna be great for those who like to take a little bit more of an adventure with their food and try something completely different that they've never tried before. Now the action doesn't just stop with this global menu. You're gonna be diving into your own superhero story and you may have an Avenger or two come and ask for your help. This is the one I'm particularly excited about. I can't wait to experience it in person. I'm a huge Marvel fan, and if you're a Marvel fan, make sure you comment down below and let me know who your favorite character is. Now, I'm not really sure if my personal favorite Marvel character will be there. I mean, he might because he now has his own Disney Plus show. I'm hoping for some Bucky Barnes action, but I'll be okay with some Black Panther too. Now this next dining experience is gonna be something completely different. This one's called 1923. It's called 1923 because that is the year that the Walt Disney Studios was founded. So when you hear the Walt Disney Studios, you automatically think Disney films and Hollywood. I'm a huge Hollywood Studios fan because I love that it immerses you in the old Hollywood ways. So I'm excited about this restaurant because that's exactly what it's doing. It's taking you back into the glitz and glamour of old Hollywood. So this restaurant itself is defined as a sophisticated dining establishment. So it might not be as family friendly as the others, but if your family loves that whole throwback look, definitely head in there. Kind of think Great Gatsby style. And what really brings the Walt Disney Studios into this restaurant is that you're going to be dining surrounded by sketches, storyboards, different types of props that are put forth at the beginning of the animation process. And the cuisine flavors here are going to be everything you can experience throughout the Golden State. Not traveling with kids, or you are traveling with kids and maybe you have someone who will watch your kids for you for a little bit of time, the next experiences are for you because we're about to move into the adults department. So you're gonna have your standard lounges and stuff, but we're not gonna talk about your standard lounge right now. No, no. The heavily themed dining experiences are not just gonna be family friendly. The adults have their own super themed bar, and you guessed it, it's Star Wars themed. This lounge is called Star Wars Hyperspace Lounge. Now technically, during the day, it's family friendly, but as it turns into night, it goes into an adults only lounge. If you've ever been to Galaxy's Edge, then you know that they theme their drinks and cuisine to Star Wars specifically, And that's exactly what's going to be happening here as well. The only difference with this particular restaurant is you're going to be transported throughout the Star Wars galaxy. Now, Disney calls this the Onboard Oasis at Sea, also known as the Quiet Cove. Now, this lounge is going to be located on the upper decks, kind of away from all of the noise, so the adults can really escape it and relax. And what better way to relax than a poolside lounge located beside an infinity pool? Now, this part of the deck is simply reserved for lounging, relaxing, swimming, and just embracing where you are. Just thinking about this place has me so calm and relaxed. Just thinking of being on a poolside lounge with a pool and then an ocean view right there. I'm already relaxed. Now, this next adults only restaurant you may already be familiar with. There are different versions of it on all the Disney cruise ships, and it's called Polo. Now, this is what they call fine dining. This is upscale. You get pampered, you get served different courses. It is a little heavier on the price point because this one's not included on your cruise fee, but it is well worth it. Apollo is inspired by Cogsworth. If you don't know who Cogsworth is, he's the enchanted clock in Beauty and the Beast. What's the cuisine for Palo? It's a steakhouse. So you can definitely expect your premium steaks and exquisite Italian dishes. Palo has two distinct dining experiences, and it's one of three Beauty and the Beast themed adults only experiences on the Disney Wish. Your second Beauty and the Beast themed dining experience is called The Rose. And of course, it's inspired by the Enchanted Rose and is reminiscent of the Beast's castle. The Rose is more of a cocktail bar. I'm sure they're going to have some little appetizers and bites you can have. This is going to be the place to find your upscale cocktails. The third and final Beauty and the Beast inspired location is called Enchanté. Now, this restaurant is inspired more by Lumiere. If you don't know who Lumiere is, he is the extremely personable and charming candelabra from Beauty and the Beast. This one is going to boast international cuisine, not just any international cuisine. The cuisine in this restaurant is crafted by a 3 Michelin star chef named Chef Arnaud Lallemand. And as Disney says, the ocean views from this restaurant give it that little bit of je ne sais quoi. So this is the information that has been provided to us so far about the Disney Wish. They may have other pool bars or other areas that you can grab drinks and cocktails from, but this is as far as we know right now. I can't wait to experience this in the future. I hope you can't either. If you're excited about any of these particular things, let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear what's exciting you about this new cruise ship. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and please make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Just a friendly reminder, don't you forget to hit subscribe and click on that notification bell so you never miss any of my videos. Have an awesome day!